Got a Meraki dashboard that needs renewing? Let's jump into how we can work out what exact licensing we need. Navigating to account.meraki.com, we then log into dashboard. Here on the license info page, we get a breakdown of all the different settings to do with our licensing. Up the very top, we get a quick glance if this dashboard is okay. This dashboard is and is not in a grace period or about to expire. If your dashboard is in a grace period or about to expire and you do need to stay online, please contact Meraki Technical Support directly for assistance. In any case, we will need to make sure we renew this dashboard by the license expiration date to make sure it stays online and we can still configure, manage, and monitor our Meraki devices. The license model is also quite important. In this instance, this dashboard is on the co-termination model. The majority of dashboards use co-termination, and it basically means even though we've got a large number of individual devices, we've got one single date at which they're due for renewal. If we opted for the per device licensing model, this is a one directional change and does mean every device is managed entirely independently. As you can imagine, this means you end up with a large number of individual licenses due for renewal at separate times. Next, we see our MX product edition. All MX devices in a single dashboard organization must be of the same type. That is all enterprise, all advanced security, or all SD-WAN plus. In this case, the MX devices in this dashboard are all advanced security. Next, we see the MR product edition. They are Meraki's wireless access points, and these can either be enterprise or advanced wireless if we want to integrate with Cisco Umbrella. In this case, they're enterprise. Finally, we can see if we have Systems Manager enabled. In this case, we do. It's then worth noting the difference between a license limit and current device count. Current device count typically reflects physical devices that are deployed on the network, whereas the license limit are the number of licenses that have been paid for. For a renewal, you typically want to make sure the current device count matches the number of licenses you're asking for a quote on. This will make sure you're only paying for the exact devices you intend on using moving forward. From here, to get a quote on renewing this dashboard, the quickest way is to send a screenshot of this license info page to your preferred Meraki partner. From there, they can help get a quote organized and come back to you with pricing. If you don't have a pre-existing relationship with a Meraki partner or would like to look at a quote from another Meraki partner, simply use Cisco's Partner Locator tool to help find a Meraki partner. Select your location and product type Meraki. Once you've received a quote back from your preferred Meraki partner, you can then proceed with a purchase. If you do proceed with a purchase, you will then be given a Meraki order number or a license key ready to claim. To claim these, navigate to Organization Inventory. We then click on Claim and are given this input dialog. From here, we enter the Meraki order number, or in the case of just licenses, we simply add the license key. During the claiming process, you'll be given one final choice: renew or add new devices. In most cases, you want to renew. Adding new devices has the effect of adding virtual devices into your dashboard. This means even though you can add more devices physically to your network, you won't necessarily push out the license expiration date. If you make this mistake, a button will appear giving you 7 days to undo an add device and change it to a renewal, or vice versa. Finally, to check you applied your license renewal correctly, navigate back to the license info page to verify this is the case.